Hello and happy Friday. Angus here at the Bureau with the key stories for the weather this weekend. First things first, if you want the latest on ex-tropical cyclone Jasper, we have a separate video on that available on the front page of our website. But for the rest of the country, hot, dry, fine weather is the key story, but that does lead to fire and heatwave risks for many. Starting off with a look at the big picture, there's certainly plenty of rain in North Queensland associated with Jasper. A couple of other areas to watch too. A weak front down here in the south brings some showers to Tasmania and southern Victoria. We're also anticipating some thunderstorms across interior Queensland both Saturday and Sunday, and that might brush past Brisbane, particularly on Saturday. Then come Sunday, a low pressure develops in southern WA, bringing showers, possible storms and gusty winds through this area here, although the current forecast is that shouldn't affect Perth's temperatures or Perth's weather too much. Let's take a look at the temperatures across the country. Still really, really warm out west with widespread 40 degree plus temperatures. That could be upper 40s for some of these areas here, with a forecast of 47 degrees around Fitzroy Crossing. Lots of high 30s and low 40s all the way out to the east coast here. A little bit cooler in the south with that cold front keeping things about 20 degrees, and a bit cooler in this region here too in the wake of ex-tropical cyclone Jasper. No major changes for Sunday. It does get warmer around South Australia, including this 45 degree forecast for Oak Valley. Still a lot of high 30s and a lot of low 40s for interior parts of the country. And with those warm temperatures, the heat, the sunshine, the dry weather and some gusty winds at times, we do see elevated fire danger for many. A couple of key focal points on Saturday include New South Wales, the north and the centre, including the Sydney metro area, is a broad region of extreme fire danger for Saturday, and a number of districts in central parts of Western Australia too. I do anticipate fire weather warnings being active for both the east and west of the country on Saturday, and likely for parts of the Northern Territory as well. Into Sunday, this east coast region comes down a notch, but still extensive high to extreme fire danger in Western Australia, including these places here, which are likely to start to pick up some gusty winds as that low pressure system develops. Finally, a look at our heatwave forecast. Remember, a heatwave is a 3-day period. In this case, it's Friday, Saturday and Sunday, where both the daily high temperature and the overnight low temperature are significantly above average. And we see a broad region where that is likely to occur through the west and north of the country, including the chance of some extreme heatwave conditions in northern WA. That's where we could see temperatures 45 degrees plus this weekend. There's a second area on our heatwave map. It's much smaller, but it's much more densely populated across the east coast here, with a pretty broad region of low intensity heatwave covering parts of New South Wales and Queensland, but a smaller pocket of severe heatwave conditions centered around Brisbane for the next 3 days. Daily high temperatures in the mid 30s with high sticky humidity values as well. Overnight temperatures a good 5 degrees above average for some, making for some uncomfortable and stifling conditions through the evening. Do take care wherever you are in these heatwave conditions. Be smart in the sun and do stay hydrated. You can always get your latest weather information at our website and our app, and we'll be giving you the best stories of this weekend on social media as well.